It was just, there was no pressure on us. We didn't have anything to lose, you know. It was just nice being able to watch the gig after. Mm. You know, like I said earlier, I thought, you know, the audience is, you know, was the best audience I've ever seen. Like, yeah, she was just no asshole.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nothing to lose when, you know, because all the tickets have gone on sale, you know, without us even being on the bill. It didn't matter. Us being on the bill was incidental, really, I think.
Mm. It was a good bill all the same, though. You could have seen yourselves and Oasis. Good value for money. When you're doing a show that size, then, what are the major differences? Obviously, it's... How do you do it? You know, it's light, it's in the afternoon.
Well, kind of like, yeah, I suppose it's the same with, like, festivals, you know. Kind of people think it's harder, but it's not, just because, you know, the audience are much farther away from you. Yeah. And, like, you're much farther away from all the band members on the stage. So it's just more of a, like, numb experience, really.
Yeah,
you know, it's just easier for it not to seem real. Yeah. But, like, the hardest thing about it is probably, like, when bands play in daylight, it's when they lose all their mystery.
So tell us about the making of the album. We know what sort of couple of years you've had, especially the last year. How pressured were you to get this right and sort of start again, start fresh, start from a different angle?
We weren't under any pressure from any kind of, like, outside influence. Like, we're just in quite a good position because our A&R man, you know, he's been with us right, you know, from the start, you know. And, like, he's a bit of a train spotter, so, like, you know, he's just really cool. And, like, we weren't under any pressure from the, you know, record company at all. We weren't under any pressure from our management. The only pressure that we had was, like, you know, obviously we were aware of the situation we were in terms of what we've been through in the last year and a half, etc. And we knew for ourselves more than anything that we had to get it right. You know, we didn't feel that this is our last chance in terms of any kind of audience.
Yeah.
Or any kind of, like, record company strategy or any kind of bullshit like that. Yeah. We just knew that for ourselves we had to get it right, because we knew we didn't have much life left in us. Mm. In terms of getting things wrong.
So, the pressure you've been, you said there wasn't a great deal of pressure, but the sort of year you've had on, personally, for the members of the band, and have you come through the other side yet? It's obviously a difficult year.
You come on a bit Jim Morrison there.
Yeah, go on.
Not really, no, you know, it's just, at the end of the day, you know, obviously you're on about, you know, kind of this, you know, you can't really avoid the Richie question and all that.
Yeah.
And
which I was trying to avoid. I was hoping, yeah, I could bring you around to what, yes, you wanted. I really wanted to leave the ball in your court,
cool,
to talk about how much you wanted to talk about.
Well, that's cool. I think professionally, you know, kind of like, you know, I can't say professionally because it's really hard because, you know, the band is really bound up with a lot of personal history because, you know, we all grew up with each other. You know, kind of, when the thing happened with Richie, I never really said all the lyricists and rhythm guitarists in our band has gone missing. It was always more on a more personal, you know, yeah, basis. You know, it's based on friendship rather than him being a band member.
Yeah.
So it's easier to overcome it in the band sense, but that's kind of, that really flatters to deceive, because at the end of the day, you know, it's kind of, you know, the personal friendship was probably, you know,
more important, obviously.
Yeah, and also kind of like, you know, you're with each other all the time, and like, you've, you know, our relationship, you know, all the band members' relationships are steeped in history because, you know, we've all known each other since we're about 6 years old, you know.
Yeah.
So, and yeah, at the end of the day, it's more of a personal thing rather than being bound up with a band. So, as the band, I think, you know, we're finding it a bit easier than, you know, the personal terms, to be honest. But it's really hard to divide them.
Okay, well, we'll leave it at that. That's well explained. So, this year now, the album, you're very pleased with the album. The single's done, it's been a great success, and the live shows are going well.
Yeah.
Does it feel like a fresh start, or do you feel as though you're always at this level?
It's kind of, you know, yeah, kind of to actually say that it's like a new beginning would be right, you know.
It's another chapter in the book, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of, you know, it just feels fine, you know. It's, to be honest, I don't know. It's kind of, I suppose, I've got some kind of superstition against trying to kind of enjoy any kind of success, because in the past, whenever I've enjoyed something, it's always gone wrong.
Yeah.
So but yeah, it is going really well and stuff.
Well, we wish you well. You're going to do a couple of songs for us today. What we're going to do, have we decided yet, James? Spilling coffee on the table.
Yeah, sorry.
It's quite all right. It's a brown table anyway, don't worry about it.
It's do a song off the album called Enola Alone, and raindrops keep falling on my head.
All right then, so take it away.
Enola Alone. Too precious to try. My heart explodes. raindrops keep falling on my head.
Raindrops keep falling on my head, just like the guy who treated you big for a head. Then nothing seems to fit. Oh, raindrops keep falling on my head, keep on falling. And I just dumb me some talking to the sun. And I said I didn't like the way he got things done. Sleeping on the job. Oh, raindrops keep falling on my head, keep on falling. I'm free. Nothing's bothering me.